Good morning, I'm MaryEllen, and today I'm going to share with you several of the items that I have purchased that I would repurchase in a heartbeat if I broke them or lost them. Some of them may be a repeat, but these are things that I actually love and use all the time. And really, in most cases, I use them every single day. And at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you some of my favorites that I had in October. Don't have very many to talk about, but I do have a few. And I'm also going to announce the winners of my last giveaway, the Emily Edit Needs and the Wants Palette. The very first item is something that I've had for a couple of months and I absolutely love. And it is a magnetic paper towel holder. And I have it on the side of my refrigerator, the one that's, you know, on the inner side of it. I don't like paper towel holders on the counter. I don't like the ones that are underneath the cabinets. I'm always kind of messing with them. And we don't use a ton of paper towels, much to Jim's dismay. But sometimes you need a paper towel. And I just put this, I put mine like this, and I just stick it on like this. You could put it sideways. It doesn't matter. But I tell you what, I love this. I wish I would have known about it. And I found it and I'm happy. If there's anything that I learned about from somebody else, I'm gonna go ahead and link their channel and mention them because I love to give credit where credit's due. But these things are the things that I found on my own. The second item, I had no idea that I would love as much as I do, but I got them last year when I got my refrigerator. And they're made by Beano, and I just took it out of the refrigerator. And I love this size. What I love about it is you can grab it with one hand and bring it out. I usually have like the condiments I like in one and the one that Jim likes. Like he likes jelly and things like that or preserves. And we can just grab it, take it out, get what we want and put it back. And you know, like for avocados and fruit and things like that, I just use those like what you get at the grocery store, the plastic containers. And they've worked, they've held up really well, but they're not as easy to grab and go as these are. But the brand is Beano. They may make some other ones that are just as good, but these are also stackable, which would be great for yogurts or things like that. These I found over a year ago, and they are the stackable magnetic measuring spoons. And it does have a leveler on top. I love these. On each measure, there's a bowl. And then there's an elongated bowl, and these are both 1 tablespoon measures. I keep them in my cabinet because if you put them in your silverware drawer, they might grab your silverware. But I love being able to have wet and dry or more narrow. I love these. I don't know how many I've purchased. I love everything I'm talking about. I need to quit saying that. I'm going to show you my backup of my next item. And I know this is over 30 years old because, yeah, I know it is. This is a butter boat. The one I'm using right now is in the kitchen and it has butter in it. But the reason I have a backup is I chipped this one time and I thought I'm gonna go ahead and keep it because if I would break the lid of the other or the bottom of the boat, you fill your water up to, there's a blue line in there and then you put this in and then just keep it on the counter and I always have softer butter. Depending on the temperature outside, sometimes it's softer than others, but I have never had anything go rancid in here. I usually put about enough butter in there that we probably will use in a week to 10 days, and then I wash it and I refill it, but I love it, and I see these things, like these butter bells that you stick in water, and like all these things, it's like they're brand new, and nobody's ever heard of them. Well, these have been around for a very long time, the butter boats. I use these all the time. When I'm heating something up, I put my bowl in here. I put it in the microwave. These are kind of like cozies for bowls. They're just perfect. And then when your soup is done or your vegetable bowl or whatever, you can just take it out and you don't get burned. And they are so handy. This would be a great item for a crafter to make because these would be great gifts. I'm not sure what's in between them, but it's two-sided. You can hang them up. I don't like to burn my hands when I'm getting my things out of my microwave. This I've had for 5 years. I've talked about this before, but I can't believe how often I use it. It's the Waymax scale, and they make a ton of different brands of them. But you, like what I do a lot is I'll put a big cup in on top of it, and then I'll put a Ziploc bag inside it. And when I have like extra chili, I will spoon it out and freeze it. But I can weigh it. As soon as I put the cup on, I can hit this button and it clears it. And then I have like even size bowls of chili. I like it. Jim thinks I'm obsessive, but I'm really not. It just makes it easy. But I weigh a lot of things. I would say I probably use this probably about 3 times a week. I used to have years ago the Weight Watchers scale. Well, this is grams and pounds, and I think it weighs up to 5 pounds. I'm not sure. I'll put that information up in here, and I will link everything below if you want to learn more about it. I'm just about out of the kitchen. I can't do a video on things I love under $20 unless I include my frother, and it is the easiest way to froth milk, cream, whatever you need to froth, and this is rechargeable, and I love it. It came with this. It's a little... like a little mini beater. I've used it a few times, but I just pretty well keep this on here. I warm up my half and half just to take the chill off, about 23 seconds. And I put this in and I froth it, and I can get froth about that high. So I don't have any reason to buy those other stainless steel frothers that look like a cup what is so easy? I have a cup of water that I put in the sink and I just put it down and clean it off and then wash it off with soapy water later, but I love it. It did not come with a stand, but here's my backup, and this is a battery operated one, and I like it too. I just don't like using the batteries, but this came with the stand, and then I had another one, you know, that I dropped when I was filming videos. So I kept this, and I just kind of squeezed this in a little bit, so this fit in here very nicely. And I've used a frother for well over 30 years. First one I bought was on QVC, and it was in the mid-80s. So I'm a frother fan. It's the simple things in life that bring me the most pleasure, for sure. I'm out of the kitchen and into the house in general. And the first things I want to talk about are the set of 24 microfiber cloths I had. That mine came in blue, yellow, and white. The blue I do use for cleaning, like wet things. The yellow I do drying off, because what I do with my good old furniture, I just take a very, just slightly damp microfiber cloth and wring it out really, really well and wipe off my furniture, and then I immediately buff it with the yellow one. That's what I use these for. And the white I use for anything with glass. But I bought these quite a few years ago and I absolutely love them. The next item is a huge deal to me. I buy the 2-year planners every 2 years. This year I have a hardcover one and a softcover one. I'm real fancy like that. That's my label. This I use for ideas for YouTube videos to keep track of my winners. And this one I use for daily, just activities of daily living. I'm gonna put a half a page up here so you can see. I have plenty of room to write anything that I want. Every month I have both sides of the page full. And I can tell you when Jim had his oil change, I can tell you when I had my oil change. I know they have those little stickers, but I mean, I just write down lots of things in here. When the prescription needs to be filled, when I need to cancel a subscription. These just have been so handy, and this is my third set because they last for 2 years. I bought these as presents, and they were appreciated. And I have to mention the pens that I use and I love, and I found these from Joan from the channel Junebug 1029, and they're the friction erasable pens. They're great for everything except for like legal documents. They're especially handy for my calendars because you can erase them. And one thing that was fun I did years ago when I heard about these, I wrote on cards for my grandchildren and then I erased it. And if they stuck it in the freezer, the message would come up. So they thought that was cool. But I always keep extra of these because I give them to a lot of people because they think, oh, they're cool. So I say, well, just keep it. So I either buy them in the big box or in the small envelope, but they're a game changer for me. Before I talked about the next item, I checked with a friend of mine who is a retired fire inspector. I sent her the link. I wanted her to look at it. She sent it to a fire engineer friend of hers to see if it was as good as what I thought it was. And it is a fireproof document bag. My children know where this is. Jim knows where this is. If anything would happen to me, everything that my children or Jim needs to know is in here. I have the titles. I mean, I have any real estate documents. I just keep anything that's important in this, and they know where to find it. And I've purchased these as gifts, and they have been very appreciative. They've never gone through a fire. They're fireproof. And I hope I never do. Knowing I have this, if I needed to leave quickly, it's not in a hard area to grab. And I'm just really thankful that I have these. And the last item I heard about from Melissa55, and it may seem like it's pretty simple, but to me, it is wonderful. And it is the Anchor phone charger. I have this on a table in my bedroom. And, you know, I use that Shildon leather phone case, and it charges through the leather. I just have to open it up and it will charge overnight, and I love it. It has a little blue dot here. It's a something very simple, but it's just so easy to set my phone in there. So this is one of my very favorite things that I would repurchase in a heartbeat. In October, Lisa J came out with lipsticks and lip pencils, and she sent me the pack of all the colors. Well, I liked them so well, I ordered some so I can give them away. And I'm not giving them away in this video. I'm going to wait till my last video of the year and do a giveaway. And I want to show you the tube. And it is beautiful. Love the color. Here's the bullet. I like the way it's slanted. I love that it is magnetic and substantial. And if you have them side by side, turn them upside down, they'll kind of stick together like that. And also a lip pencil. I'm going to go ahead and show you how I got this look this morning. And this is probably about 3 hours old, and I haven't touched it up. I always start with dry lips that don't have any lip balm or anything on since the night before. And what I did, I put Inner Beauty all over my lips, and it goes on so smoothly and feels so good. And on top of it, I put the color Passion, which is a deeper color. And then I added the lip liner Sweet Pea. And that's what I've had on during this whole video. I think that this may become my very favorite formula of lipstick. I can't say it yet. I have some more. What I've been doing is putting like lipstick when nobody's here except for Jim. I'll put like one of my faves on this side, and then one of BK Beauty's on this side, and see how it lasts. This will last a good 5 hours, and even if it didn't, I'd still like it because I love the way it feels. That's what's the most important to me, is the way something feels on my lips. I want to be able to pick up the lipstick and put it on without looking in the mirror if I don't want to, and this definitely hits all the marks for me. But I'll let you know later if it is my favorite, because you guys know what some of my favorites are. So anyway, I'm so happy for Lisa. Thank you so much, Lisa, for sending these to me. I appreciate it so much because, number one, I think she is such a good person. She gives a percentage of her revenue to an anti-bullying program. And I'll link her video where she demonstrates the lipsticks. And I do have a 10% off coupon for you, and I'll put those below in the show more section. Something that really made me happy in October, you know, we could open up our windows. Well, Jim likes to fry things. He still fries things, and he puts it in a skillet, and well, those grates get really bad because I'm not on top of it. And I know how quickly ammonia can take care of it, but you can't use ammonia unless you have good cross ventilation. Well, I poured some pure ammonia in a Ziploc bag, big gallon Ziploc bag, put my grate inside, sealed it up. I had it in an aluminum pan, and overnight, just left it overnight, took it out, rinsed it off, and I'm not kidding you, they look brand new. So I kept the same ammonia, stuck another one in. I did it 4 consecutive days, and they are just shining. I can't believe what a great job it did. So I only used 1 Ziploc bag, and I'd add a little bit of more ammonia in the bag, but it didn't take very much. And I think it's the fumes that clean it, but they're just sparkling. And as far as television, I finished Anne of Green Gables, and thank you all for encouraging me to finish it. The bad guys didn't hurt him, so I watched it, and in fact, I'm going to watch it from the beginning again, because I started that probably 2 years ago, and then once I kind of got a little bit scared, I thought, well, I'm not going to finish that, and then you all encouraged me to. Loved it, and I'll tell you, when it comes to entertainment, I don't have the best memory of what happens, so that's why when I go back in and watch it again. Now, if it's something important, if it's something with healthcare, if it's something financial, I have got, or if it's a documentary, I will remember it. But if it's entertainment, it's like my mind chooses, oh, that's entertainment. You don't need to remember that. So I think I remember enough about it, but I'm going to go back and watch it. And I'm still watching Manifest. I probably watch one a week or a couple a week. I'm on season 2, episode 11. I've enjoyed that. I've enjoyed watching The Voice and Project Runway. I always enjoy Project Runway. I want to give you an update on Jim. Right now, we're thinking it may be January when he gets his left hip replaced. November is taken. There's a slight chance that it could be in December. We're going to jump on it whenever they say. And after he heals from his left hip, they're going to do his right hip. And I'm just hoping and praying it goes okay, because he's had a really hard time getting around. But I want to thank you for your prayers. I really appreciate it. And your good vibes and your good thoughts. And he reads some of the comments, and it makes him feel good. I hope you all that are celebrating Thanksgiving this Thursday, I hope you have a lovely time. And it's a nice time of the year. We have, no matter what is going on, we have so many things to be thankful for. I've gone through rough times in my life, but there's never a time that it could not have been worse. It always could have been worse for me. And now I want to announce the winners of the giveaway. Here's a palette that I'm gonna be giving away. And this is the Emily Needs, and this is the Emily Wants, and I'm going to order them and have them sent to you. Now I would like to announce the three winners of both Emily Noel's palettes, the one I used during this Get Ready With Me, and also her Wants palette. The first name that came up was Brenda Joseph. Congratulations, Brenda. The next name that came up was Joe A. Congratulations, Joe. And the last name that came up was Sinel. Sinel, congratulations to you. Congratulations to all three winners. Make sure you leave me a comment below, and I'll let you know how to get in touch with me. I have a different email just for winners in here. And if you don't live in the United States, we may have to do something different, but you can just let me know that in the email. And my next video is going to be my collaboration with Natalie the Beauty Diva and Carol from The Old Carol Show. And this year, we're going to only have 10 of our favorite items from 2021. And in January, I started listing everything. So it's going to be hard for me to narrow down to 10 items that we're going to do it that way. We've done this for years. So that will be the first Sunday in December. It is all good. Thank you so much. I appreciate you for hanging in there with me, for being supportive, for sharing my videos with your friends. I will see you in my next video. Take care. And I'm also that I would buy, I just noticed my sleeve wasn't buttoned. Any reminders, any